So let me welcome each one of you today evening. We have an esteemed panel, of course. Let us understand how this real estate has been growing after the COVID impact. The topic today is from each sector as to how they have been able to overcome for the last 18 months impact on the COVID, how the business has started growing, what is the impact. So maybe we'll start with the first one, Amit Goswami. You are into elevators because that is a, in fact, the we call it as a lifeline of the building, and we know in Mumbai or in metros, the multi-story buildings, without elevators, nothing can happen. So you are with Kone, and yes, let me first ask you, this COVID, last, of course, few months, there must have been complete lockdown. However, now it has started. What we understand is now it has started opening up. And how you see, as far as your sector is concerned?
The biggest impact that you actually see is we're all wearing masks, right? So we're scared to, I was just asking, should we remove the mask? So that's one of the things. But more importantly, the businesses came down drastically. Almost all except, of course, hospitals are doing well, pharmaceutical companies, digitalization went really up. So I think the impact was so immense that the real estate sector, and this is of course there in the data, has come down by 30-35% at that point in time. And but there's been a positive side to it as well. We now can talk to our customers and to our teams virtually. So we've learned to talk to them virtually.
MD of Martin Engineering. So from the your perspective, you can just tell us from your industry perspective how things are evolving, how they are coming back.
I mean, here I have to really say that we have done this year the highest ever service inception in terms of all the performance, whether it is in terms of the sales performance or the financial performance. This is the best year for us. But yes, there are challenges. These same commodities which we are getting benefited on one side, we are also manufacturers, so we have to buy this at a much higher rate. So we have no other option, but we have to also increase our prices to the customers. And but if you look at the industry, this increase in the commodities price or the increase in the consumption, it is definitely a good thing for the country as such. Because cement, steel, they are the main ingredients of infrastructure also. Amit mentioned about the real estate, but it is also about infrastructure. So when infrastructure is growing, India is growing. And so that is the big advantage that we see.
Professor S. Khanna, so he is from IIT and he is the chairman of SSPC.
Of course, the life in the last 1.5 years or 2 years has not stopped. So fantastic use of internet and very good methodology of so-called virtual meetings has created a totally a new scope for discussions, meetings, which requires so much of flying, so much of meeting each other and then discussing same thing. So that has really created a very positive thing. But definitely you miss something which you cannot judge, especially when you make a kind of a teaching program. So what I just wanted to say that one of the sectors which has been very highly affected by this pandemic is the education.
Rashmi Kolatkar, she is the director of Builder Environment India. So from the environment,
present the environment here.
That's correct.
My company name is Building Environment India. We have seen in WhatsApp that dolphins in many and like Mumbai was looking so beautiful in zone when first lockdown was there. So we know that environment is there, like we extend the hand and it will like reappear in our lives, because we took the cities as very basic line that like they are polluted and we have to accept it as a polluted cities, and we are adopting that lifestyle. So this is not the case. We should like go for like serious about the environment, because climate change is real. So regarding this pandemic, the one country-wise challenges, I would like to say that there is huge biomedical waste is there, like which was formed because of COVID. And the plastic was banned earlier, but it is now reintroduced because of pandemic. So huge plastic waste is also there, so which has to be yet addressed by government. So this is the whole country-wise challenge, because this is just there and it is not like looked after. And for individual business, for my business, I would like to say that our most work has been done on PC and internet, so it is not technically affected. And even initially it was efficiency was raised up of employees because of they saved a lot of traveling times and all this. It is again affected us differently, because suddenly in January, when partial lockdown was there, lots of environmental employment opportunities was raised, and we actually lost our 25% of staff because they like got jobs somewhere else. So
we have in the sales Ranjan.
Yes,
sir. He's the zonal head of AIS Glass Solutions. Yes, sir.
Yeah, so I represent glass industry. So glass kind of most talked about waste material. So yeah, it is said about the glass that you can love me, but you cannot ignore me. So what happened to this product in the pandemic? So three things basically happened. First was about the survival of the business, because there was a huge issue of the cash flow and everything in the whole industry, not only for any company. Then second was introspection and consolidation. And then third was the business continuity, because glass business has a kind of very inherent challenge, which is that you cannot stop the production. If you have a supply, demand, no demand, you have to keep on producing. So for the whole time of the lockdown, all the factory of the glass were just producing it, breaking it. Yes, so this actually impacted a lot for the profitability. Then we discussed about the price. So yes, people are talking about price has been increased. I would say price is corrected now, because price is increased so that I should earn more margin. But here we are not earning the margin, because the price is increasing in the complete value chain. The biggest challenge of this whole thing is that finally the whole price increase will be passed on to the end consumer. And I'm not sure till what time they will be able to sustain it, because the per capita income is not increasing.
Yes, sir.
So yes, it has to be a balance. But at the same time, there are some silver lining in the global market scenario. One is the shipping cost has increased, I think, multifold, 5 to 6 times, which has literally stopped the import of the glass.
We have with us Vikas Kumar. I think the MD of Nava.
For everyone, we manufacture plastic foam works in India, and we do it in two plants, one in Delhi and one in Bangalore. Foam works, as many people don't recollect, it's shuttering and centering in the normal way, what you call it. So in our case, what I would say is we've benefited quite a bit from the pandemic. One thing was, I think we all got a chance to set back, consolidate, think about how to build it up further. And the initial first pandemic which happened, in that actually the first 2 months was okay. More of introspection on what we were doing and how we need to get ahead. That time the prices of our raw materials were the lowest at that time. but and people were actually expecting that because of the pandemic, the prices are going to further go down and the demands are going to go even further down. So I think most of the manufacturers didn't build up any inventory. We were all on minimum inventory at those times. But it was a different game altogether. Immediately after that, the prices started shooting up, and today I think if I look back in this 1 year, 70-75% increases in most of the items, plastics as well, steel, every segment. I don't see any segment which has come down.
That pandemic, you had a little bit setback, and now market has started picking up, and I think in a days to come, if by worst case, third wave does not impact, I think the growth path can be seen. And everywhere we are reading in the Economic Times and Times of India, everybody has started having a growth of 10-15% volume wise, and I'm talking about the minimum. In fact, even my industry where I'm doing consultancy, the consultancy also has started going up.
I think so you've gained the maximum.
That's true. So I congratulate each one of you and thank you very much.